Welcome to the visual art presentation for your up-and-coming subject selection consideration. I'm Brooke McLaughlin and I run our beautiful visual art department here at St John's. Choosing the subjects you want to study in Year 11 and 12 is an important undertaking, and there are a number of factors that you need to take into account. Most importantly, you need to ask yourself,
what subjects do I enjoy?
Will my subject choices help me reach my career goals?
Are there any prerequisites for my chosen career or tertiary course?
Do my subject choices cater to my strengths by representing my abilities and interests?
Am I keeping my options open in case I change my mind?
Do I have a balance of theoretical and practical subjects?
Will my choices develop skills, knowledge, and attitudes that will help me throughout my life?
Some things not to select subjects based on is what you believe they might scale to, and also being influenced by other people's choices about what they think you should do. Visual art teaches you to deal with the world around you. It is the oxygen that makes all the other subjects breathe. Studying visual art is so important because it provides students with skills needed in the workplace. It teaches you to be a problem solver, a communicator, creative and innovative. It is the foundation of so many career options. There are so many jobs. Visual art is the type of subject that prepares you for jobs that may not even exist yet. It equips you with essential 21st century skills. All of the 21st century skills are embedded within the art curriculum, including critical thinking, creative thinking, communication, collaboration and teamwork, personal and social skills, and information and communication technology skills. Visual art future-proofs you with skills that cannot be replaced by machines. These are most importantly your ability to think creatively and critically. Senior art is a two-year course covering two units in Year 11 and then two units in Year 12. In Year 11 you have an excursion and your assessment would include four formative tasks for the year: a small 15% presentation on your experiments and two practical folios, then an exam at the end of the year. Your Year 12 summative assessment layout is the same, with a stimulus experience excursion on which you will base your 15% experimental reflection, then two practical folios, followed by the external exam. You will have the opportunity to explore an enormous range of media areas and the flexibility to decide on which materials you would like to work with more extensively. This includes two-dimensional, three-dimensional, and time-based media. It is great if you had studied art prior to joining senior visual art. However, it is not essential. We invite you all to join in on this subject area if you are interested. The excursions are loads of fun, and we go on one in grade 11 and in year 12. Every year we have our annual College Creations art show that you have the opportunity to exhibit in and help create the displays. Art will equip you with all the skills necessary for success. Employers are looking for creative thinkers and innovators and people that can work both independently and collaboratively. It will teach you determination and resilience and help develop your own sense of identity and value. Art is a subject that you can spend time on here at school and at home as well. It will teach you time management skills and is a fun way to spend your time. It is also a fantastic way to balance out your academic commitments and keep your options open for a variety of career paths. The art room is always open for you as a senior student. It is a place where you can be yourself and express your ideas, feelings, and individuality. So why is studying art so important for the future of our world? Pyramids, cathedrals, monuments, and rockets exist not because of geometry, a series of structures, or thermodynamics, but because they were first a picture, literally a vision in the minds of those who built them. Society is where it is today because people had the perception, the images, and the imagination, the creativity that the arts provide to make the world the place we live in today. Think about what you could make it be tomorrow. Arts and cultural learning encourages awareness, empathy and appreciation of difference and diversity and the views of others. We need more of this in the world right now. You don't have innovation if you don't have the arts. It's as simple as that. People who do art are inventors. Your imagination can become reality. Did I mention how many jobs that art is useful for? Plus, art is loads of fun. If you have any questions at all, please don't hesitate in contacting me.
There's a deep desire in us to make pictures. I mean, they've been drawing for 30,000 years. The teaching of drawing is teaching people to look. That's what it's doing.
It was really when I was at art school that I started to see the relationship between history, philosophy, politics, and art. Prior to that, I thought that art was just making pretty pictures. Actually, art is connected to, you know, life.
You can't teach art in the same way you can teach French. French exists whether you do it or not. But when you're doing art, the center of doing art is in yourself. Most of the literate subjects do not ask that of them. So this develops an entirely different realm of skill.
Creativity is critical thinking. And without it, how are you going to really open up and ask harder questions? And art opens all of those kind of passages and possibilities to think beyond what we already know.
In a child's education, that doors need to be opened to other universes, other modes of thinking. And art is a non-prescribed, dangerous world full of possibility. And I think that's a vital space for children to have in the formative years of their education.
From a top-down level, you don't have innovation if you don't have arts. It's as simple as that.
It doesn't matter if you're going to study history or geography or science, you still need to be creative, because the people who are the outliers in those fields are the most creative people. To have art in schools be eroded, which is happening at the moment, is disastrous for Britain, I think, because our best industry is the creative industry.
Art and cultural production is at the very center of what makes a society what it is. And for an entire new generation not to know what is the cultural and visual history of ourselves is kind of denying our own identity.
Art is a reflection of the society that we are, the kind of mirror that art holds up, the way that art helps define the identity of a nation, that you can trace that back. Historically, it's deeply embedded in humanity.
What art education does to people who are not going to be artists is giving them the opportunity to build certain aspects of themselves that otherwise will be either ignored, undeveloped, or repressed.
It's all about kids finding out who they are, and they're all different.
That you can be whatever you want to be is something that art certainly taught me. It can access a part of your brain, body, spirit, mind that nothing else can.
Nothing is more stimulating, exciting, consoling than looking at a brilliant painting.
Art in schools shouldn't be sidelined. I think it should be right there, right up in the front, because I think art teaches you to deal with the world around you. It's the oxygen that actually makes all the other subjects breathe.
There's a great quote by John Ruskin: art shows us what it is to be human. And really, that's why art should be on the curriculum.